Seahawks logo and they sang Sweet Adeline.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Joe Biden doesn't have time for malarkey, and he also doesn't have a lot of time for geography. Take a listen.
The people of Nevada are watching, and I'm going to be out there seeing them very soon. Tonight, though, we just heard from the first two of 50 states. It's important that Iowa and Nevada have spoken, but look, we need to hear from Nevada and South Carolina and Super Tuesday states and beyond.
And Biden doesn't know the difference between Iran and Iraqis.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Today it is my honor to nominate one of our nation's most brilliant and gifted legal minds to the Supreme Court, Judge Amy Coney Barrett. This should be a straightforward and prompt confirmation. I'm sure it'll be extremely non-controversial.
I'm anxious. I am scared.
And she has very closely held views that will impact a woman's right to choose.
Justice Ginsburg must be turning her over in her grave up in heaven.
Still in heaven? You're still dead?
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
The New York Times yesterday began publishing that series of reports that examine 20 years worth of the president's tax returns.
This is one of the most important stories of the past 5 years.
This is so incredibly significant.
Revealing financial losses in the millions and payment of almost no federal income tax.
Well, it's simply a matter of creative accounting.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
It doesn't include property taxes. It doesn't include payroll taxes. It doesn't include real estate taxes. It doesn't include so many of the things that he's been paying taxes on forever, as he's also putting thousands and thousands of people to work on an annual basis.
Unchained and unstoppable.
But of course, the New York Times does this the day before a debate to try to give someone like Joe Biden, you know, an attack line. They come up with one or two catchy sound bites.
That crazy old loon, he needs all the help he can get.
That's why I made it a priority in my entire career to work closely with you. From the time I got to the Senate 180 years ago.
Travel back in time with me to 1840.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
Do you like paying taxes? Do you try to pay more taxes than you can if you take advantage of the tax code of the United States of America? I'm just perplexed by how this story gets. I'm not perplexed, I guess. I understand it. They, you know, any port in a storm. I mean, this is the week's scandal or the day's scandal. You know, I forget what Bob Woodward was angry about, but oh, he downplayed the coronavirus and the Atlantic story and about the disrespecting the dead World War I veterans and just going back all the way. Well, this is just the newest one, just in time for the debate. And it's just pointless. I mean, think about this. This story appeared in the New York Times, okay? The New York Times. In the early 1990s, the New York Times was on a buying spree. They bought the Boston Globe, believe it or not, for $1.1 billion. They bought the Worcester Telegram, even more amazingly, for $300 million. They spent $1.4 billion on two dying rags. 20 years later, they sold the two papers that they'd spent $1.4 billion on for $70 million, which is basically the real estate, the building in on Morsi Boulevard in Boston. Then I think there was a printing plant at the time in Billerica or Taunton somewhere. I think keep switching them around. Billerica, I think. And then there was the Telegram building in downtown Worcester. That was the only value. The newspapers were and continue to be worthless. So the reason I bring this up, this doleful chapter in the New York Times corporate history, is do you think they took a tax write-off for their losses when they dropped almost $1.5 billion on two rags? I mean, it's just amazing that we're all supposed to forget these things. And, you know, one thing about Trump that they've been angry about for a long time is he said, I can't release my returns because there's an audit going on. So, of course, all the fact checkers said there's no audit going on. It's all BS. He's just making it up. It's another lie on the list of Trump lies. Well, now the New York Times has illegally obtained his tax returns, and it turns out there is an audit going on. And if he tries to, if he loses the audit, if they rule against him in the arbitration, he could end up owing about $100 million. So the reason he got this tax write off that really helped him out a lot is because he put all of his he put a ton of money into the casino in Atlantic City, and the casino rolled snake eyes. It went belly up, and so he lost a ton of money. And so then they accuse him. He said that he could take the write off. One, the loss of the casinos because he surrendered full control of the casinos. According to his tax returns, he did not release full control. He still owns 5%. 5%. Oh, okay. 5%. So, they've been obsessed for 5 years now. Almost 5 years with the Russian collusion hoax, and we'll be talking more about that with Joe DeGeneva again today. I've read the entire 302 of that FBI agent who was in on the Mueller angry Democrat witch hunt. It's just amazing. It's just appalling how bad it was. I mean, it's pretty disturbing stuff, even if you understand some of the earlier FBI scandals like the one in Boston. But we'll talk more about that in a bit. So, do you know what the biggest score he made in Russia, according to the New York Times? He had that Miss Universe pageant in Moscow. That's the one where they made up the stuff that he was with the hookers and all that stuff. Do you know how much he made on that? This is his biggest score from the Russians. $2.3 million. That's it. That's the biggest score he made. I mean, that's good money. I wouldn't turn up my nose at $2.3 million, but I don't think that's enough to sell out the United States of America. 844 500-4242. And, you know, the other thing is, this is like Rachel Maddow. Remember when she said when she had the big exclusive scoop that he had not paid any taxes for some year in the 1990s. I think it was 1996 because he lost all this money, and she portrayed it as some giant scoop. And then it turns out that he had written about this in the intro to one of his books. I mean, it had been out there for 20 years that it had taken this kind of write-off. This is just all nonsense, you know? And another thing, too, here, and this got no publicity last month when the story was written. Joe Biden, when he got out as vice president, he set up something called an S corporation to avoid paying hundreds of thousands of dollars in taxes. This was the headline in the Wall Street Journal on August the 10th, how the Bidens dodged the payroll tax. So they figured out a way to avoid funding seniors' entitlement benefits. According to their tax returns in 2017 and 2018, this is the Wall Street Journal, the Bidens and his wife Jill avoided payroll taxes on nearly $13 million. $13.3 million in income from book royalties and speaking fees. They did so by classifying the income as S corporation profits rather than taxable wages. So they gave themselves a nominal salary out of this corporation, and the rest of it they handed out to themselves as disbursements, as profits. And you don't have to pay payroll taxes on the disbursements. So they saved tons of money, hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars. But now the Biden campaign had a new ad ready to go just as the New York Times story broke. It was almost like there was some kind of coordination between the Democrats and the New York Times. Just like there was almost some kind, just like there almost seems to be coordination between all of these scandals. They all come at like intervals where they could be milked for as much as they're worth. You know, some of them are worth less than others. And none of them are worth very much. But they always have some way to continue the narrative. So this morning I'm driving around, driving to work, and I'm listening to the ABC News on one of our affiliates, and they talk, bombshell announcement in the New York Times, his taxes. And then you know what the second bombshell story was? Florida reopening under evil Governor DeSantis, even though there's been a grim milestone. For indeed, that was the phrase they used, grim milestone. A grim milestone of 700,000 cases, or 700,000 positive cases, or 700,000 tests. All I know is it wasn't deaths, because deaths are so April 2020, aren't they? So it's just a litany, a drumbeat. And it's not even, they know most of the people that are going to vote for Joe Biden aren't going to read the stories. I think most of them are barely capable of reading, but perhaps they can comprehend the headlines. And so they see Trump evaded taxes, and that's all that really matters. It doesn't matter if it's true or not, or it doesn't matter if Joe Biden is doing the same damn thing. There's no reality to any of these stories. That's why it's very fake news. Very fake news.
Very fake news.
Exactly. Exactly. 844-500-4242. And I'll just mention this one more time. I just want to read you the exact quote, because remember they've accused him over the years of lying about having an audit, and that's why he can't release his taxes. Also hanging over him, this is the New York Times, the very fake news New York Times, is a decade-long audit building with the battle with the Internal Revenue Service over the legitimacy of a $72.9 million tax refund that he claimed and received after declaring huge losses. That was the casino in Atlantic City. An adverse ruling could cost him more than $100 million. So he was telling the truth. He was telling the truth. 844-500-4242. Joe Biden has never been asked about all of his S-Corp write-offs, has he? Because they don't do that with dementia, Joe. That would be unfair to someone with dementia, wouldn't it? 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
A nightmare to liberals everywhere. He's Howie Carr.
Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Good thing Roman makes treating erectile dysfunction simple, safe, and from the comfort of your own home. Get a free online evaluation today at GetRoman.com/Howie. If approved, you'll get $15 off your first order of erectile dysfunction treatment.
Hey, Howie, I see you got a haircut again.
Yes, I did, Grace. It looks good, doesn't it?
It definitely looks better than that haircut you got a few years ago before you met the president. Remember that bad buzz cut, Howie?
Geez, you love bringing that up, don't you?
Well, I just think that your bad haircut was a true testament to the wonderful work of Dr. Hines at DiStefano Hair Restoration. Because even though you looked crazy at the time, your hair grew back, and now you look as dapper as ever.
That's true. Dr. Hines did such a wonderful job on my hair. I love waking up every day not worrying about bald spots or a dreaded comb over. I now have a thick head of hair, and the best part of it is, it's my hair. Getting a DiStefano hair restoration was the best decision I ever made.
Well, besides hiring me, right, Howie?
Like I said, Grace, it was the best decision I ever made.
You heard him, guys. Go to hairman.com to get the hair you've always wanted. Get hair like Howie's. Go to DiStefano Hair Restoration. They have 5 locations in New England, and they are open for business. That's hairman.com.
Mike Bloomberg is spending millions of dollars on all of his campaign ads, but we put together some of our favorite Bloomberg clips, and guess what, Mike? This one's totally free.
I think we disproportionately stop whites too much and minorities too little.
To be a farmer, it's a process. So you dig a hole, you put a seed in, you put dirt on top, add water, up comes the corn. Then we had 300. You could learn that.
Donald Trump is the world's biggest schoolyard bully.
Big gay ice cream is the best.
The Communist Party wants to stay in power in China, and they listen to the public. When the public says, I can't breathe the air, Xi Jinping is not a dictator. He has to satisfy his constituents, or he's not going to survive.
He's not a dictator?
No, he has a constituency to answer to.
I'm ready to get to work, so let's get it on.
I would be 79 years old when I took office. To start a 4-year job, maybe an 8-year job at age 79, may not be the smartest thing to do.
Why did you say what you said in that 2015 speech?
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
Brace yourself, guys. Here is 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
I myself have always been for lowering the voting age to 16. I think it's really important to capture kids when they're in high school, which was a very amiable conversation, I guess you would say, not amicable.
That they wanted their voices to be heard.
I don't think our colleague is anti-Semitic. I think she has a different experience in the use of words. That's not the total package, but there are some of the major points of discussion, I would hope, from sea to shining sea, because they are not getting paid Republicans voted no. Wisdom from the kitchen of the Willard Hotel, yes, ma'am.
The president either doesn't know what he's talking about or doesn't want to know what he's talking about.
This is Mark in Williston, Vermont.
This is Marie in Somerville, Massachusetts.
This is Mike from South Attleboro, Mass. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Good thing Roman makes treating erectile dysfunction simple, safe, and from the comfort of your own home. Get a free online evaluation today at GetRoman.com/Howie. If approved, you'll get $15 off your first order of ED treatment. GetRoman.com/Howie. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Are you concerned over President Trump's tax returns?
No.
Yeah, 94% say no.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. I tried this morning to get some numbers out of the State Department of Revenue. So you know how tough that is to get anything out of a state agency, especially in this COVID crisis.
Wasn't he pretty much divested from all of his earnings anyway in 2015 and 2016?
Well, he was making big money out of The Apprentice, and he was using the money. He was like the co-producer of The Apprentice, and it was the number one show on TV for a few years. So he was minting money on that thing, and that's how he was buying some golf courses. He loves the golf courses, and apparently they're losing money. But you know what? Here's the thing. Anyone, you don't have to be a mogul. If you've just made investments here and there, you bought two or three houses over the years, you know, tried to go from one to the other, you start out with a fixer-upper, handyman special, move up to a better suburb, et cetera, et cetera.
you're going to make a bad investment or two along the way.
Well, he's really investing in the real estate, not the business operations of the golf course. He probably doesn't even really care about that.
Well, I don't know. He makes money off they said he makes money off the Trump Tower. He makes money off Mar-a-Lago, too. But here's my point. You have good deals and you have bad deals. If you play the game, whatever the game is, whether it's football or real estate or any or stock market speculation, you're going to win some and you're going to lose some. And to make it seem like so they have a choice now. Either he's this powerful mogul billionaire. He has more money than he should have as president of the United States. Or he's this bust-out businessman. So they're trying to portray him today in the New York Times as both. He's got too much money, he's a tax cheat, but he's also a business failure. So I don't know which it is. And someone just says, my local paper said Trump avoided paying taxes. So I thought, gee, so did I. Yeah, exactly. You know, I tried to get the numbers from the Department of Revenue today, like I said, for the latest tax year. For how many people in Massachusetts avoided paying at the higher rate? You know, you can pay at a voluntary higher rate. The legislature passed that as a joke of 20 years ago or so. And it's a good joke because it really puts the lie to all the liberal protestations that they want to pay higher taxes. They didn't give me the numbers. I don't know why. But I'm going to try to get some more numbers. But the most recent numbers I saw were from March of 2 years ago, March 2018, 2,027,000 people in Massachusetts had filed their taxes. 2,027,000. Do you know how many had volunteered to pay at the higher rate?
I'm going to guess zero.
Well, there are a lot of nuts in this state, Taylor, and there's 7 million people here. 894, close to zero, very close to zero.
Statistically close to zero.
Yeah, and those
I was
people,
within the give or take 1,000.
And those people, I've done the research before in earlier years, and those people that wanted to pay the higher rate, they averaged about $10,000 in income. So they're not too many people making livable wages who want to pay that kind of money. 844-500-4242. Jack, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Jack.
First off, two quick points. I love your show. I love listening to you guys. You are amazing.
Thank you.
Second point I want to make, I wish you would be on Fox more often. We'd love to see you more. Now, what I want to say is I'm excited about watching the debate tomorrow night and see what Mr. Trump does. The only thing that scares me a little bit with Chris Wallace is the president likes to repeat himself.
Yes.
You know, he'll say something over and over again.
Right, like
and,
a blues singer. Yes.
I guess, but I'm just concerned that he'll get off track and Chris Wallace will pressure him to give him a straight answer.
Nah.
And
I don't think that's the problem, Jack. I think the problem is going to be is more likely to be that he asked Trump tough questions, but he asks Biden softball questions, because that's been the MO of Chris Wallace for many, many years. He's a Democrat. He's a Democrat operative with a press pass. All right. Thanks, Jack. I'm Howie Carr.
Let me tell you about a new sponsor to the Howie Carr Show, Helping Hands of America. For over two decades, Helping Hands has made donating your car, truck, or boat to a New England charity incredibly easy. I've donated and you should too. It takes one call. The pickup is not only fast, but it's free, and your donation is 100% tax deductible. Call Helping Hands at 888-881-9090. That's 888-881-9090. Or visit helpinghandsofamerica.org. Restrictions may apply.
Do you have no water, poor water quality, or low pressure? This is Howie Carr. Call the local water service experts, Skillings and Sons. They're ready with 24-hour service with no extra charge for after-hours calls and a fleet of trucks stocked with parts to make sure you're not without water. With over 50 years of experience, they take pride in having a family of employees that are the best in the business. For all things water, Skillings and Sons is there for you. SkillingsandSons.com.
Joe Biden accuses Trump of being a racist, but if you listen to Biden's comments, you would agree that he doth protest too much.
If you take a test where you're taking cocaine or not, what do you think, huh? Are you a junkie?
He's the first mainstream African American who is articulate and bright and clean.
And Madam President, we have predators on our streets.
That kid wearing a hoodie may very well be the next poet laureate. And not a gangbanger.
They are beyond the pale, many of those people.
God love you, you've been here all day. My Lord, you may feel like you've been incarcerated.
We have no choice but to take them out of society.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
I think the two-party system is good for the South and good for the Negro.
They're gonna put you all back in chains.
Unlike the African-American community, with notable exceptions, the Latino community is an incredibly diverse community. With incredibly different attitudes about different things.
If you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, and you ain't black.
With all the uncertainty in the world, feeling safe at home has never been more important. It's why I want to talk to you about Simply Safe Home Security. They're longtime friends of the Howie Carr Show, and for good reason. Simply Safe has made it easy to finally get comprehensive protection for your home. There's no technician or salesperson that needs to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay any outrageous monthly fees or sign a two-year contract. You just order online, set it up yourself in under an hour, and your home is protected 24/7 with emergency dispatch for break-ins, fire, and more. All for just 50 cents a day. And we're not the only fans of Simply Safe. U.S. News and World Report named Simply Safe best overall home security of 2020. Go to simplysafehowie.com to try it out for yourself. That's simplysafehowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. That's simplysafehowie.com. The Moonbats always say Donald Trump isn't very bright. But what about Barack Hussein Obama? Let's listen to some of his greatest hits.
I've now been in 57 states. I think one left to go.
I don't know what the term is in Austrian.
The Cambridge police acted stupidly.
And there has never been any man or woman more qualified for this office than Hillary Clinton.
There are neighborhoods around the country where it is easier for a 12 or 13-year-old to purchase a gun and cheaper than it is for them to get a book.
I believe in the Second Amendment. It's there written on the paper.
If we fall for, you know, a bunch of okey-doke.
A few months ago, when you were asked what's the biggest geopolitical threat facing America, you said Russia, not Al-Qaeda. You said Russia. In the 1980s or now, calling to ask for their foreign policy back.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy now.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much. But no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gooner since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gooner is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time at Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. Joining us now on the news line is Brian Morgenstern, the White House Deputy Press Secretary. Brian, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show.
Hey, it's an honor to be with you. Thanks for having me on.
Listen, a professor at Boston University, alma mater of Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, said yesterday, he tweeted out that Amy Coney Barrett, because she adopted the two Haitian kids, she is a white colonizer. Any reaction from the White House to that charge?
Yeah, good Lord, what an awful thing to say. She is a loving and devoted mother. Her children love her. Her children that she adopted, Vivian was a baby, I think she was 11 pounds at 14 months old. She was malnourished. The children needed to be cared for, and the Barrett family took them in, and they've raised a beautiful family. These kids are great kids. They had a lovely visit with the president and the vice president the day of their nomination. Judge Barrett is an outstanding mom. She's an outstanding attorney, outstanding professor, and a great judge. She's eminently qualified, and she is a warm and kind person, endorsed unanimously by the clerks that worked with her at the Supreme Court from all across the political spectrum, endorsed unanimously by the faculty at Notre Dame Law School, where professors are all across the political spectrum. I mean, this is a person who is so highly respected, highly regarded, and known really universally as just a likable, kind, thoughtful person. You know, wackadoo attacks like that, I think, will do more to turn people off than they will to persuade them. And I think that the left knows it, and that's why you're even seeing some senators threatening to just throw their hands up, take their ball, and go home, because Judge Barrett is such a sterling nominee that that they don't want to fight with her, because they think that they'll look bad for doing it. And I think this sort of attack just sort of proves that out.
Well, you have senators like Danang Dick Blumenthal, the Stolen Valor Senator from Connecticut, and Mazie Hirono from Hawaii, who has a record of rabid anti-Catholicism. They're already saying they're not even going to meet with her. They can't be bothered to meet with her.
Yeah. Yeah, and you're already seeing some of the attacks that we just mentioned, and that's what I'm saying is these people who, first of all, will prejudge the nominee and not even give her a fair hearing because they're convinced that they're going to lose anyway. And so literally this is the best they can come up with, is just saying, I'm not going to participate. Well, that should show the American people that President Trump has picked a nominee who will be confirmed on the merits, because her opponents can't figure out what to attack her for. If you're going to attack a person for being a person of faith, and claim that someone can't be a fair-minded judge and be a person of faith, well, then you're attacking virtually every justice who's ever served, including Justice Scalia. You know, nobody asked Justice Ginsburg if she would be some kind of radical Jewish justice, because it would be a crazy thing to ask. So this way that they're, some are starting to attack Judge Barrett, I think really just shows how little they have to even stand on in terms of criticism.
Let me play a sound cut for you from Al Sharpton, a noted legal scholar, about the late Justice Scalia. Cut 12.
Yes, I'm concerned about Roe versus Wade. I'm concerned about voting rights when she says that Antonin Scalia was a mentor.
Antonin Scalia.
Yeah, I think if he's going to start criticizing an American judicial legend, he should start by learning how to pronounce his name. How about that? Just presuming how she would judge any particular case that isn't even before the court is just grasping at straws. It's just desperation. Judge Barrett is someone who is chosen because of her sterling credentials and because she will uphold the Constitution and the Bill of Rights. And that's what every American should want in their judges. Frankly, the harebrained reaction from the left should show you how far off the deep end the Democratic Party has gone when saying, I want a fair-minded judge who will uphold the Constitution, is controversial. I mean, the fact that sort of a statement would even be controversial shows you just how far off the deep end they've gone.
Is the president disappointed that they're not going to start the hearings for basically 2 weeks? I mean, what's the delay? Why can't we start them this week?
Well, I mean, that's really a question for the Senate. You know, the president's done his job in putting forth an outstanding nominee, and we are pleased to see the Senate moving pretty quickly. I mean, based on how fast this process has moved in other circumstances, it's moving along pretty quickly. It's not as fast as others. I mean, Justice Stevens, I think, was confirmed in 2 weeks, so it's not as fast as that, but it is a little bit faster than we saw with Justice Gorsuch and Kavanaugh. Bottom line is, it's well within the norms to have a thorough vetting of this candidate, which the American people deserve. I mean, this is a lifetime appointment. We'll have a thorough vetting, but it will be rapid and it will be fair. I mean, at least that's our hope. So as long as we are on track to do this, as soon as the Senate can, hopefully before the election, because I think that would be the appropriate thing to do to get this thing done so that we don't have any kind of political gamesmanship after the election. It would be better to do it before, and the Senate seems on track to do that, so that's a good thing.
Now, the president is going to come out shortly and have a, I don't know if it's just a briefing or he's going to take questions about the coronavirus testing. And I know he's also preparing for the debate today. What are his preparations? How is he being trained? Who's he with?
So the president talks to a lot of different people, and he takes feedback and he bounces ideas off of them routinely. It's just kind of part of his personality. It's how he has always approached things. And, you know, furthermore, through the way he does his job as, I think, the most transparent president in history, taking questions from very hostile reporters on a near daily basis, addressing criticism from Democrats, very much in contrast to the Democratic nominee, who I believe called the lid again at 9 a.m. or something.
Right.
The president, of course, exposes himself to tough questions and is transparent with the American people. So he certainly has a lot of training, but he also speaks privately with very smart people and bounces issues off of them as well.
I heard he was training with Rudy Giuliani and Chris Christie, who I know helped him out in the last campaign with these debates, because Chris Christie is pretty good at these things. Is he at the White House today?
I haven't seen him today. I did see him there over the weekend, along with Mayor Giuliani. I've not seen them today, although it's a big place, so they may have snuck past me. But I generally like to say hello to them when they're here. And yeah, the president mentioned yesterday that they were helping him out.
My producer says it's hard for Chris Christie to sneak past anybody. But you know Joe Biden's got a lot of experience though that he can fall back on. I'm sure you heard this cut when he was talking about his experience earlier this weekend. Cut one.
That's why I made it a priority my entire career to work closely with you. From the time I got to the Senate 180 years ago, you know.
Certainly feels that way, doesn't it? It feels like it's been 180 years. I mean, he's been around a long time. He does not have a good record to show for it. And it is really a stark contrast when you look at the president in public service for 3.5 years, and he got the most inclusive economy we've ever seen put together. He has a record of judicial nominations that I think is unmatched. He has a national security record that includes getting our troops out of harm's way and forming new peace deals that we think will only lead to more peace deals. I mean, the president's record in public life is really exceptional, and he will put that up against Joe Biden's very undistinguished 47 years any day of the week.
Correction, so 180 years, Brian, 180.
Sorry. Well, he can last so long because he's well rested. He gets a lot of sleep.
Did he go out and do the that impromptu press conference at 5 o'clock yesterday, knowing that the New York Times was about to break this quote unquote bombshell story that the mainstream media is going crazy with today?
Oh, I don't think he came out and did it because of any particular story. He likes to give updates on what's going on. You saw in his opening remarks, it was some of what he would say in political settings that doesn't necessarily get carried by the networks. He wants to make sure that people hear what he has to say. Certainly his contrast with the other side, but also just to provide updates on what's going on economically, what's going on with our coronavirus response, issues that are very important to the American people. So, I mean, he does this for a while. It was near daily. Sometimes it is daily, depending on the week, but it's never in response to any particular story. It's always because he has a lot to say about the hard work he's doing.
Well, Axios is reporting that Joe Biden is going to concentrate on the death toll, which could be a real problem for him, since he said the death toll is anywhere from 200 to 200 million, depending on what day it is. So that
who knows what it'll be tomorrow? My goodness, you know, it's not something that we like to joke about. We don't want to see anyone harmed. We don't want to see loss of life, of course. But just the fact that the former vice president is so all over the map with his comments, I think is certainly something that everyone should pay attention to. I mean, if 200 million people are passing away, Howie, it's been nice knowing you. I'm sorry that neither of us may survive this interview.
That's on top of the 150 million that he said were killed by firearms since 2007. You know, I mean,
well, there's not going to be any people left. No, to vote.
Well, we don't have to wait for 10 years for the world to end, as AOC says. So, all right, Brian Morgenstern, thank you for being with us, and give our best to the president, and we look forward to the debate tomorrow night, and we think he will acquit himself well, shall we say. Thank you, Brian. If you haven't tried Super Beats soft chews yet, you're really missing out. They are a great boost of energy. They're very healthful. They're wrapped in tin foil like a piece of Halloween candy, if we had a Halloween still. And you just take a couple with you in the morning, and they'll be great for you. They give you a boost of energy. They're good for your blood pressure, and they're good for your circulation. They're just
just what the kids need on Halloween. You giving out Super Beats, going home to their parents, all wired up more than they would be on Butterfingers.
I'm not giving out Super Beats, but anyway, I will be in Florida by Halloween, so Halloween will be observed in Florida, if not in Massachusetts. Anyway, Super Beats soft chews combine non-GMO beets with a powerful new ingredient, grapeseed extract. The grapeseed extract used in Super Beats soft chews has been clinically shown to be twice as effective at supporting normal blood pressure as a healthy lifestyle alone. Better blood pressure means more energy the way nature intended, without the jittery caffeine or stimulants. Now you can take just two delicious chews a day, anytime, anywhere, to get the blood pressure support you need and the energy you want. It's great. I take one in the morning, even before my first cup of coffee, and then I have one before I go on the show, just to give myself a little boost of energy, and it really pays off. I can't recommend them highly enough. I like the powder, but this is even more convenient and easier to deal with. Do what I did and support your heart health today with delicious Super Beats Chews. Get your Super Beats Chews today at superbeatsradio.com/Howie, and when you buy two bags, they'll throw in the third for free. That's superbeatsradio.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
He's suave, he's debonair, he's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Route 1 Grill House in Saugus, located just before the Cactus. From their steak tips and ribs, the Route 1 Grill House has it all. Open now 7 days a week for both outdoor and indoor dining.
President Trump's life has changed a lot in the last couple of years, but one thing that remains consistent is love for a good nickname.
What happened to Minnie Mike? Where is he? Minnie Mike, I've had him up to here. Sleepy Joe has no idea what he's even talking. He doesn't even know what he's talking about. Sleepy Joe, get off the stage, please.
I don't think the guy's got a chance. Sleepy Joe, I don't think he's got it.
I don't know. I think Sleepy Joe may be able to limp across the finish line.
Crying Chuck. I don't want to say Crazy Nancy, because if I say that, you're going to say it's a copy of Crazy Bernie, and that's no good.
Who did you? Alfred E. Newman. You know, I thought Pocahontas was gone, left in embers. I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year.
Did you ever hear of Pocahontas? It's Pocahontas, Elizabeth Warren.
Little pencil neck Adam Schiff. Got the smallest, thinnest neck I've ever seen.
But Nancy Pelosi, I call her Nervous Nancy.
Crooked Hillary.
Crooked Hillary Clinton.
Bill Clinton said to Crooked Hillary, Crooked Hillary, do you think he calls her Crooked Hillary, Mike?
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day, once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
There are plenty of differences between Trump and the Democrats running for 2020, but the main one is Trump's pretty funny. Take a listen.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president.
I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay? It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, I never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be. I'd be the world's worst.
Other countries, big countries, India and others, we had to pay because they considered them a growing country. They were a growing country. I said, what are we? Are we allowed to grow too? Okay. No, are we allowed to grow?
I try like hell to hide that bald spot, folks. I work harder. Doesn't look bad. Hey, we're hanging in.
I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year. Because I've destroyed her political career, and now I won't get a chance to run against her, and I would have loved it. I don't want to knock out all of the good stuff and end up with somebody that's actually got talent. That would be terrible.
This is Jeff in Woodstock, Connecticut.
This is Laura Benner in South Burlington, Vermont.
This is Jimmy Mack in Falmouth, Massachusetts. And this is The Howie Carr Show.
By the way, I did a column today for the website only, HowieCarrShow.com, just about basically what we've been talking about today and what we're going to be talking about today on the show. So if you want to check it out, it's easy to read in bullet points. Go to HowieCarrShow.com, and it's right at the top of the page. 917 says, so if it's okay that Sotomayor is a wise Latina, she said that, right, at her confirmation hearings, then why can't Barrett be a devout Catholic? Because Sotomayor toes the party line, and Barrett doesn't. And then he continues, Barrett is a monster because she adopted two black kids, but it was okay for Madonna, Sandra Bullock, Angelina Jolie. Yeah, exactly. Again, as long as you got the D after your name, it's anything is okay. You can even make Tara Reid go away if you're Joe Biden. 844-500-4242. Bill, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Bill.
Hey, Captain, how are you?
Good.
I just wanted to remind you of the incredibly funny line that Donald Trump delivered to somebody back in the 80s who asked him, Mr. Trump, how do I become a millionaire? And he replied immediately, it's simple. You start off as a billionaire, then you buy an airline. And I loved it. And but that's very topical. Because
no, it is. The airline, I remember Trump Airlines. They flew out of Boston. I used to see him usually I was taking Eastern back in those days, I think. But yeah, you're right. I think he lost a boatload of money on the airlines in addition to losing a boatload of money on the casino in New Jersey, right?
And he lost his boat. The yacht had to get sold.
Yeah.
So but that's one of the things when you try to explain it to people about concepts like the net operating loss carryover.
Depreciation.
Depreciation schedules, and Trump doesn't pay any taxes. Can you imagine the property taxes he pays?
No, I just think about Mar-a-Lago. I know what I pay on my little condominium in Palm Beach.
Mar-a-Lago!
Can you imagine what he pays in property taxes? And you know, and you talk about, you know, he makes bad deals. He bought Mar-a-Lago for a song, really. I mean, compared to what it's worth now. And I mean, he's made a lot of good deals. He's made more good business deals than he's made bad business deals, or he'd be out of business. And you know, he's not the only guy who's come close to being down the tubes. I mean, Rupert Murdoch, the guy who owns Fox News Channel and the Wall Street Journal, and Fox News and the Fox Channel on the network spectrum. He almost went out of business in the late 1980s. He was one phone call away from having all of his notes called in and being bankrupt. He had to make a call, I think it was to the Mellon Bank in Pittsburgh, and basically beg this guy to give him an extension on his credit. A lot of people have been, a lot of people that are billionaires now have been bankrupt in the past. They just get up off the mat and keep going at it. That's the way you got to be in life, right? Thanks for the call, Bill. Nick, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Nick. You there, Nick? Go ahead.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes.
Hey, how you doing? Hey, Howie, I was listening to the soon, hopefully to be a fossil, Kyle Bernstein today, telling us how much of a grifter Trump is,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Think about this. He's given his entire salary, $1.6 million, right? To charity, okay?
Right.
If you look at Obama and the fabulous Mr. Biden, they don't do none of that. If you look at Biden from 1998, I believe, to 2009 when he became a vice president, him and his fabulous wife, I believe they average about $320 a year to charity.
I saw that. Forbes did a chart on that. And a couple of years, it was down around $100, Nick. Same thing with John Kerry when he was running for president. He gave zero money to charity until he married the second heiress. You're right. These Democrats, they'd give you the shirt off of somebody else's back, but they themselves throw around quarters like they were manhole covers. I mean, it's just BS.
Can I get out of here, please?
Shut up. Yeah, you can get out of here. Just you know, leave some money in the poor box. I know that would break your heart, John Forbes Kerry. He's fascinated by rap, you know, kind of like Kamala Harris. I'm Howie Carr. Eden Pure will continue their buy one, get one free promotion for the Thunderstorm air purification system all week long. Eden Pure is able to do this due to the huge success from the Howie Carr Show listeners. The response has been tremendous, and Eden Pure is passing on those savings to the listeners. The Thunderstorm is a small device you can hold in your hand and plug into the wall. The Eden Pure Thunderstorm works like a real thunderstorm. It quietly sends out super oxygen and ions to kill odors in your room. Over the weekend, I saw my daughter Carolyn, and she asked if she could have one for her basement in her new home. She asked if it really works, and I said, of course it does. You won't believe it. If you bought one for your home and enjoy the big difference in smell, take advantage of the BOGO offer now and buy one for a family member like I'm going to do for Carolyn. Go to EdenPure.com and put in code word HowieBOGO. That's EdenPure.com. And with code word HowieBOGO, shipping is free.
Remember the boy who cried wolf? I call this one the press that cried Hitler.
The president is not only racist, he's a bigot, but he is completely un-American. He is behaving like a fascist.
This is the president once again just thumping his chest and acting like he is the dictator that I think he wants to be. The
president of the United States is a wannabe dictator with authoritarian tendencies.
This is exactly what authoritarians do. This is what strong men do. This is what happens in authoritarian regimes.
We have a president with a strong authoritarian personality.
Like a dictator from another nation.
People that grew up in authoritarian regimes, seeing echoes of that in President Trump. He likes these figures like Vladimir Putin and Kim Jong-un.
This is more the actions of a dictator.
He totally wants to be a dictator. It's so obvious.
Much like Hitler took over the Nazi Party, Trump has taken over the Republican Party.
He went full Hitler.
Trump is as destructive a person in this century as Hitler, Stalin, and Mao were in the last century.
It's simply a Stalinist phrase, for God's sake.
He sounded not like a president of the United States. He actually sounded like Saddam Hussein.
The Democrat Party is so full of loonies, social justice warriors, progressives, whatever you want to call them, that sometimes certain moonbats get overlooked. So let's take this moment to shine the woke spotlight on crazy Maisie Hirono.
I am not going to be a fool to Mitch McConnell's shenanigans. Why should any of us?
And it's not just a dog whistle, it's a bullhorn.
Bullhorns. It's racism. It's basically, for many people, it's anti-Semitic. It's white supremacy.
Why not take a stand and vote yes for it? Seems like you're trying to have it both ways. Not be hung by it politically, but also not say that you don't support it.
I disagree with you, Katie, that why should we engage in the kind of sham shenanigans that Mitch McConnell is really good at?
I'm confused.
This was just a sham.
Guess who's perpetuating all of these kinds of actions? It's the men in this country, and I just want to say to the men in this country, just shut up and step up.
I think the noose is closing, and, you know, Giuliani is like a loose cannon, and so is the president, frankly.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon start at about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. buyraycon.com/Howie.
Here's 1 minute with Governor
Charlie Parker in Massachusetts.
I'd certainly put myself on that list. I'm a basketball player. I always was.
There's a lot at stake here.
This is not a virus to be trifled with or disrespected.
Respect the virus.
I have a hard time understanding when we're going to be able to play basketball again.
We can start talking about a gradual, careful, data-driven, phased reopening. Don't let a few nice days step on that.
I need to talk to the Attorney General and find out what the actual parameters of the ruling are. Did this just happen? And the reason I read that story is because I'm a basketball player, and I agree.
I was first made aware of the discrepancy on this on the day that the registrar resigned.
The vast majority, and I mean like the vast majority of the people who are part of these protests, are there to make a point and to make it peacefully. That is so obvious, I'm amazed that anybody could say anything other than that.
I would love to be able to open everything up tomorrow. That would be an incredibly irresponsible thing to do.
He's New England's talk radio king. He's Howie Carr.
The only French term I like is sans culotte, without trousers. I used to describe Ted Kennedy as sans culotte. Because after the O'Barr incident, when he was wandering around down on the beach with his 20th Scotch tumbler of the day in his hand, stumbling around with an off. He was just there, as the Michelle Cassone, Patches Date, said. He was just there, without trousers. Or as we say in Paris, sans culotte.
We've seen nothing that we can work on. That I can work with President Bush on, and I'm disappointed because I thought that there might be some interest because of what he said in the campaign.
President Bush, this is your brain. This is your brain on Botox, okay? That's the lesson of that one.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Are you aware that the Episcopal Archbishop of Washington and the presiding bishop of the Episcopal Church nationally all denounced this police assault on the civil rights and civil liberties of the people?
Did they do that before or after the fire was put out?
Do you want to rephrase what you're doing? Because I think the word spying could cause everybody in the cable news ecosystem to freak out.
I'm not sure of all the connotations of that word that you're referring to, but, you know, so, unauthorized surveillance.
Okay, thank you.
Is that more appropriate in your mind?
This is your call. I really did want to give you a chance to say it how you wanted to say it and make sure that you didn't misspeak.
How can you sit here and tell us why should I investigate the President of the United States if you're not even aware of the fact
facts concerning the president using the pardon or commutation power to
require, you know, a reliable predicate before we open a criminal investigation.
Do you think that this body right here would rise up if they decided to go tonight and paint the Capitol building?
This body, I'm not sure.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
Normally, we give Fredo Cuomo a lot of attention, but lately, it's Governor Andrew Cuomo who's been grabbing headlines. Let's take a listen to some of his best moments.
You're an essential worker, so go take a job as an essential worker.
But the people aren't hiring because of the
pandemic. There are people hiring. You can get a job as an essential worker. So now you can go to work and you can be an essential worker and you're not going to kill anyone.
The number is down because we brought the number down. God did not do that. Fate did not do that. Destiny did not do that.
We're not going to make America great again. It was never that great.
Because I can all see you are in masterful shape, buff even.
It has a very...
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Today it is my honor to nominate one of our nation's most brilliant and gifted legal minds to the Supreme Court, Judge Amy Coney Barrett. This should be a straightforward and prompt confirmation. I'm sure it'll be extremely non-controversial.
I'm anxious. I am scared.
She has very closely held views that will impact a woman's right to choose.
Justice Ginsburg must be turning her over in her grave up in heaven.
Still in heaven? You're still dead?
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
The New York Times yesterday began publishing that series of reports that examine 20 years worth of the president's tax returns.
This is one of the most important stories of the past 5 years.
This is so incredibly significant.
Revealing financial losses in the millions and payment of almost no federal income tax.
Well, it's simply a matter of creative accounting.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
It doesn't include property taxes. It doesn't include payroll taxes. It doesn't include real estate taxes. It doesn't include so many of the things that he's been paying taxes on forever, as he's also putting thousands and thousands of people to work on an annual basis.
Unchained and unstoppable.
But of course, the New York Times does this the day before a debate to try to give someone like Joe Biden, you know, an attack line. They come up with one or two catchy sound bites.
That crazy old loon, he needs all the help he can get.
That's why I made it a priority in my entire career to work closely with you. From the time I got to the Senate 180 years ago.
Travel back in time with me to 1840.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
Welcome. What a bombshell story from the New York Times that President Trump uses the tax code to his own advantage, unlike every other American who pays taxes, right? Joe Biden uses the S-Corp loopholes to avoid paying Medicare taxes on his $17, $18 million that he made when he was out making speeches and getting advances on his really, really well-written books, which I was the recipient of a book from the mayor of Boston. And thank you, Marty.
That might be a good question by Chris Wallace, too, to ask Joe Biden. Do you, if you win the presidency, do you plan on forfeiting all of your money that you are supposed to make to a charity? And if so, which charity? Because we know he doesn't have a lot of experience with charities, mm-hmm.
as far as personal contributions go. He doesn't give a lot of money to charity.
When it comes to charity, he wouldn't pay a nickel to see a volcano, Grace.
But he would say tithing, thank you to the
tithing is one of the many words Joe Biden does not know the meaning of.
And I don't mean to be rude, but it's just so frustrating when they act like this is such a big deal because they don't ask any questions about their guy. They never mention the fact that Donald Trump doesn't take a salary, which I'm sorry, but you can say it's not a big deal because he has so much money, but all of their people took money.
Right.
Obama never said, oh, I'm not going to... Oh. I see this all the time on Twitter, and it never fails to resonate with me when they say, I'd rather someone who made it big and then became a politician than someone who became a politician and then made a ton of money.
Right.
And it's true.
I'm much more suspicious of somebody who came into office making like $40,000, $50,000, and then 30 years later, he's a multimillionaire living on top of the Ritz-Carlton in D.C. I'm not talking about you, Harry Reid. You know, just for an example. But, I mean, there's innumerable numbers of them, including Republicans.
Yeah.
Look at Denny Hastert. I mean, the crooked House Speaker from Illinois, who I think went to jail for, you know, lying about paying off his high school students that he was charged with molesting. I mean, all these people, they're not even lawyers, and they get some of them, like Ryan, like Paul Ryan, like Dennis Hastert. They get big jobs in law firms as quote unquote lobbyists. It's just influence peddling is what it is.
Right. And a lot of the vibe I was getting from people on social media was, if first of all, this is not going to change anyone's mind who's voting for Trump. And second of all, for a lot of people, we don't like paying taxes. I mean, maybe the Democrats are different than us, but I don't like paying taxes. I know Donald Trump doesn't like to, so it's not a bombshell at all.
I'm going to share again for the Newsmax audience the numbers. In Massachusetts, one of two states in the union, the other one being Arkansas, where you have an option on your state income tax form to pay more money. You just have to check a box.
Oh, the Elizabeth Warren
line 22.
Option.
Yeah, Elizabeth Warren never signed it. She wanted higher taxes. John Kerry never signed it. He wanted higher taxes. All these people that wanted it. So I couldn't get the most recent year results, or at least I haven't gotten them yet from the Massachusetts Department of Revenue. So I went back to one of my old columns from 2018, March of 2018, 2,028,000 Massachusetts residents had filed their income taxes. Of those 2,028,000 people, exactly 894 had decided to pay voluntarily at the higher tax.
Wow. They should get their heads checked.
And I remember doing the math a couple of times on that, and the average person who checked the box was making about $12,000 a year.
It's absolutely insane. But I do want to talk about something else besides this bombshell. I want to talk a little bit about what happened this weekend with Amy Coney Barrett. She was nominated by President Trump. They had a little ceremony in the Rose Garden. Howie, it was so awesome. I mean, just hearing all of her accomplishments and how qualified she is, and then all of her children getting to go up there with her. And one of her daughters was looking at her with such admiration. And it was, I remember watching it and saying, they're going to have a really, really hard time dragging this woman through the mud.
Yeah. Someone just mentioned, I'd forgotten about this. I actually broke this story. Liawatha, the fake Indian, claimed that she made an accounting error. Remember the accounting error? Mm-hmm. And she wrote off $50,000 worth of clothes. $50,000. And She didn't spot it until I pointed it out to her campaign.
Oh, right.
It's just
you're a good proofreader.
I could be a forensic accountant.
You should be on her campaign.
If I wasn't a columnist and a radio talk show host. And how about the Clintons? Remember the Clintons when he was the governor of Arkansas, making pretty short money? I think he was the lowest paid or second lowest paid governor in the country. They were taking write-offs on their used underwear. $3 per pair of underwear, and I think $3 for mildewed shower curtains.
Ooh.
But Donald Trump's a grifter.
Well, by the way,
unlike Elizabeth Warren or the Clintons.
Can we drill down a little bit on the hypocrisy of any talking head at MSNBC criticizing someone else for taxes?
Yeah.
Am I wrong or am I right on that?
No, you're absolutely correct. We have to play a cut. This is a cut we played in the first hour, but this is going to amuse everybody. We put on the loop sometimes Al Sharpton's greatest hits about how he just totally fumbles whenever he tries to pronounce any name or any word with more than three or four syllables.
Howie, please give him some R-E-S-P-C-T right now. He is a great speaker. I don't know what you're talking about.
Is he a freeloading fraud, as some of the Massachusetts congressional delegation has been calling Trump today? But anyway, this is Al Sharpton over the weekend on MSNBC. The Reverend Al. He's a man of God, you know. Cut 12.
Yes, I'm concerned about Roe versus Wade. I'm concerned about voting rights when she says that Antonin Scalia was a mentor.
I believe you're misquoting. I don't believe she says Antonin Scalia is her mentor, Reverend.
But Howie, it's a really good example, because I saw this a lot this weekend on social media, where so many people expect us to believe within the last 48 hours they're now experts on the judicial system, on the Supreme Court, on the tax code, on Amy. People who haven't ever probably heard Amy Coney Barrett's name until 48 hours ago are now telling me that every door RBG opened, it was just so Amy Coney Barrett could close it behind her. It's ridiculous. People don't even care until they think it's going to be politically beneficial for them, and it's really pathetic.
And incidentally, 207 wants to know if the New York Times next release of confidential income tax returns is going to be Hunter Biden's.
Oh, I would love
so we can
to
see.
See
well, I want to know, did he pay income taxes on that $3.5 million he got from the mayor of Moscow's wife, the one who was fired by Vladimir Putin for being so corrupt?
Howie, kids are off limits. Don't ask about Hunter Biden. You know better than that. Guys, when we get back, I have tons of more news to get to, including a really crazy story about a teacher in France, but also more about Trump and Biden in the debate tomorrow. Howie, do you mind if I give a quick shout out, though?
Go ahead.
I want to give a quick birthday shout out to my mom, Jean Curley. She's the best lady in the whole world, and I hope she has a fabulous birthday. She totally deserves it.
Happy birthday, Jean. And is there any update on the urinalysis test tomorrow night? Is Joe Biden going to bring a Whizinator to Cleveland?
Trump is tweeting about it, and I don't think it's going to happen, but it's amazing, because if you type in debates on Twitter and you just see if you just read the room, some of the tweets I come across blow my mind. People are like, ugh, Trump is going to get praised if he can put two words together. I'm just thinking to myself, wait, do you really, what universe are you guys in? You understand it's the exact opposite. If Joe Biden comes out wearing pants, he will be the next president of the United States. But then again, that's a toss-up. We don't know.
I'm Howie Carr.
Howie Carr. You can trust him. He's not like the others.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to the .com and Interco.